Hi, welcome to Math Antics. In our last lesson about percents, we learned that there are three main types of percent problems because there's three different numbers that could be missing. Those three numbers are the part, the total, and the percent. They're just the three variables or changeable numbers in the percentage equation. The fourth number is always 100, since that's what percent means, per 100. In the last two videos, we learned how to solve problems where the part was unknown and where the percent was unknown. In this video, we're going to learn how to solve problems where the total is unknown, or missing. With this type of problem, you'll be told what the percent is, and you'll be told what part of the total you have, but you'll need to figure out what the total itself is. Here's an example of a problem like that. Your friend has a bag of marbles, and he tells you that 20% of the marbles are red. If there are 7 red marbles, how many marbles does he have altogether? Okay, so how do you know that it's the total that's missing in this problem? Well, the word altogether is a big clue because it means almost the same thing as total. So if the question has words like altogether, or in all, or total, or whole, or entire, those can help you know that you need to find the total. And another way that we can tell is by the numbers that we are given. In this problem, we know that the percent is 20, and we're also told that part of the marbles are red, so we know that the part is 7, so that means that it must be the total that's missing. All right then, so how do we figure out what the total is? Well, using a little algebra, which you don't need to know how to do right here, we can rearrange our percent equation like this. What this new form of the equation tells us is that if we take the part and multiply it by 100, and then we divide that by the percent, we'll get the total. That seems simple enough. It's just two steps. Let's try it out on our word problem about the marbles. We know that the part that are red is 7, so step 1 is to just multiply that part by 100. 7 times 100 is 700. And in step 2, we take that 700 and divide it by the percent, which we're told is 20. Okay, 700 divided by 20. Well, we could use a calculator to divide, but this doesn't seem too hard, so I'll just do the division the long way. 20 is too big to divide into the first digit, 7, so we'll need to include the digit next to it as well. Now we ask, how many 20s does it take to make 70, or almost 70? Well, that would be 3, because 3 times 20 is 60. 70 minus 60 leaves 10 as the remainder, and then we bring down the 0, and then we ask how many 20s we'll divide into 100. Aha! 5, because 5 times 20 is 100, so that leaves no remainder. So 700 divided by 20 is 35, and that means that the total number of marbles is 35. And in a problem like this, you can always check your answer by making sure that the fraction of the part over the total would give you the correct percent. For example, in this case, you can make sure that the fraction 7 over 35 would really be 20%. Now that wasn't so tough, was it? Let's see one more example to make sure you've got the procedure down before you try some on your own. The next problem says, a high school marching band has 12 flute players. If 8% of the band members play the flute, then how many members are in the entire band? Okay, so the smaller part in this problem is 12, since there's 12 flute players, and we're told that they make up 8% of the band, so the percent is 8. Again, it's the total that's missing, and to find it, we just need to follow our two-step procedure. For step 1, we multiply the part by 100. 12 times 100 equals 1200. For step 2, we divide that 1200 by the percent, which is 8. This time I think I'll use a calculator to divide. 1200 divided by 8 equals 150. Great. That means that the total number of band members is 150. And again, you can always check your answer the way we did in the last example. All right, that does it for this lesson. Remember, the key to getting really good at math is to do it yourself. Doing practice problems on your own will help you become a great problem solver. Good luck, thanks for watching Math Antics, and I'll see you next time. Learn more at mathantics.com.